please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
I'll tell you, I mean, I was looking at the construction space in some detail today.
Right.
A company like Dilip Buildcon, which by far is the largest in market cap,
in that space.
Right. The projected consensus earnings are about 75 rupees for FY20.
Right.
It puts it at under 10 PE now with this correction, right?
Yeah.
The high was, what, 1,300 rupees? It's 650 or something.
Correct.
You're
absolutely right. I mean, so I don't want to obviously comment on specific names, but if you look at construction sector on the whole, the government is giving out more orders for roads. The order books for some of the large industrial companies, construction companies are doing reasonably well. So if you don't have a balance sheet risk, I mean, that's the stuff to look out for. I mean, a lot of these construction companies could potentially have balance sheet risk. If you do not have a receivables problem, if you do not have a balance sheet risk.
Dilip doesn't.
I know. So, and if you have a good order book, good visibility, you know, the stuff is cheap. I mean, I think it's attractive.
Uh-huh.
And you can't call the bottom. Uh-huh. Okay. So will stocks be down another 10% or 20% in the next 3 months? I can't say.
I mean, actually, PNC, Jay Kumar, Gayatri, what, KNR.
The whole lot. The whole sector
so
is
looking
down.
So you find value there?
Yes,
what else? Are there pockets like this?
And contrarian, since you're saying that there's merit in sort of looking for value in the not so obvious areas, and what else is on your radar?
So pharmaceuticals, right? The entire healthcare space is completely bombed out. While it has picked up a little bit in the last month or two, the reality is the stocks are still down 50-60% from their peaks 2.5 years ago. I think the fundamentals are repairing themselves. These are all foreign exchange earners. Yes, there is a possibility that trade war throws up some nasty surprises at us, and that's something that I can't price in, I can't predict. But barring that, I mean, these stocks are looking very good. In the domestic industrial space, construction space, things are looking good. Industrial banks are looking good to us. There are a whole bunch of small companies addressing very small markets, some in export, some in domestic economy. Small and mid-cap is a very interesting space. There are a whole bunch of diverse things, and a lot of them are looking very interesting. Stocks that are down 40-50%, I think people should look at them, reassess the fundamentals. If the fundamentals haven't deteriorated, if the balance sheet is in a good shape, if the cash flows historically have been strong and the management has a reputation for probity, you should buy it and wait it out for the next year
or two. One thing I hear sometimes is that